Hi Stampers, it's Kim Vogel with the Basement Bunch Stampers, and I'm here for another terrific Tuesday video. Today I'm going to share with you a really quick and simple gift card holder that I made using nothing but a little bit of designer series paper and an actual envelope. This is our medium envelope, and I'm going to show you how easy it is to put together this awesome little gift card holder or money holder. I made mine birthday themed, but this would also be something you could do for Christmas or anything else that you might want to incorporate with a little gift card holder. So it opens up here on the side. I've just tied a little knot on the side. And when you open it up, you have in here a little gift card spot right here that I've created for you to be able to put your money or your gift card in there. And then a birthday wish. And then I simply close it up and tie it with some ribbon that I used to wrap around this. Now, the designer series paper that I chose to use today is the Partesian Blossoms Specialty Designer Series paper, and I love this paper. It has, the colors in it are Pool Party and Petal Pink. And then there's also some champagne color and some cherry cobbler that goes into it as well with other different patterns in the paper pack. But I chose to use the piece of paper today that focuses more on the pool party and on the petal pink. So let's go ahead and get started making this card today. All you are going to need is one of our medium Whisper White envelopes. Now, we also sell these in vanilla. So if you were doing something where the paper had more of your vanilla tones in it, or neutral tones, you could use the vanilla envelopes as well. And then I have a piece of cardstock, and I chose to use the Pool Party because it will go nicely with my designer series paper. And the designer series paper is cut, let me look at my own notes here, 2.5 by 4. And then the cardstock is cut 2¾ by 4¼. So it's gonna nest on there perfectly, 1/4 of an inch smaller the paper is. And we're going to go ahead and adhere those two together. So here you can see on the back side, it incorporates more some of that cherry cobbler color into the paper pack. So you could actually make some of these in different colors if you wanted to, if you purchased this paper. Now you can order online from me 24/7. I have an online store where you can buy any of these awesome supplies that I'm using today to be able to complete these projects. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to move this out of the way, and I'm going to bring in our Whisper White envelope, and I'm simply going to fold this in half. Oh, mine got a little dirty, but that's okay. I'm going to fold this in half, and if you have a bone folder, you want to make a really good crisp fold on this. I'm just going to kind of push it down with my finger there. And then what you're going to do is you are going to cut down this flap down to the fold line right there. So I'm going to bring in some scissors, and I'm just going to cut down until I get to that line right there. And then you can use a circle punch. Now I'm using a 2-inch circle punch because it's what I have here in front of me, but you would probably want to use something that's maybe a little bit smaller. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring my 2-inch circle punch in here if I can. And I'm just gonna kind of punch out this little pocket just a little bit to give it a little bit of a notch there. So you can see if I would have had a smaller punch, I could have done it over a little bit. You'll see here in my sample, that's what I did, but you want to cut a little notch out so that people have a little hole to be able to go in here and get their money or their gift card out of there, okay? And then what you're gonna do is you're just gonna seal this side up. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. Just lick it and seal it. And then what we're gonna do is we are gonna cut this flap off. Now I'm gonna show you something fun that I do with this flap because I don't like to waste too much stuff. Sorry, let me get back in here so you guys can see. So I just cut straight across that. I forgot that I zoomed in a little bit farther for you guys today so you could see my small project better. So here you can see we have the envelope. This part is taped down. Again, here's your little opening. Now, before we adhere this down here, we're gonna add the ribbon around it, and I'm also gonna stamp my sentiment. Now on this one, I stamped my little greeting on this part, but you could also decorate this part up if you wanted to as well. To keep it easy and simple for today, I chose to just do the one, and I'm gonna stamp the I'm using the stamp set. Let me show you the stamp set I'm using. It's the Peaceful Moments stamp set, but I love it because it's got so many great greetings and sentiments in it. So I am pairing the happy birthday with the wishing you every happiness the special day will bring. So the outside's going to say happy birthday, and then the inside's going to have this sentiment right here. So let's go ahead and stamp that sentiment. I'm bringing in my black ink pad, and I'm going to ink this up really good. Hopefully I ink it up really good. And I'm just gonna go ahead and stamp this down right here on the side where I'm gonna be putting my money and everything. So there's my sentiment. And you wanna let that dry before you close it, because you can see here in my sample, I didn't, and I got some black marks all over. But that's okay. Again, you know, it's handmade and people love handmade stuff, so. The next thing you're going to do is you're going to incorporate the ribbon. So what I did is I put the ribbon underneath this little piece of designer series paper and wrapped it around on the back, and it's adhered on, and then I just tied it shut here at the ends. Now this ribbon is the Petal Pink 1/4 inch metallic edged ribbon, and it is gorgeous ribbon. It's so, so pretty. So let me go ahead and fold this. What I did is I went ahead and added some adhesive right to the center of this little envelope, all the way along the front part. And what I did is I brought my ribbon in, and I wanted to leave about a good 6 to 7 inches to be able to tie that, okay? So I'm gonna leave that much over, hang over, and I'm just gonna go ahead and put this ribbon right down where I have the adhesive line. And then I'm just going to turn it over. So again, you can see the amount that I have left over there. And I'm going to kind of do the same thing on this side. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to add some adhesive. And I'm going to just do the same thing here. Bring this right around. And then I'm going to cut, let me bring my ribbon over here. I'm just going to cut this at about the same amount on each side. Okay, so, and if you have too much, you can always trim it after you tie your card, your gift card shut, but I like to make sure I have enough. So there you can see, I just wrapped the ribbon around it like that, okay? And that adhesive is perfect to go right along the back. It sticks that down really nice. From there, I'm gonna go ahead and add my front on here. Now again, the sizes for these two pieces are, the designer series paper is 2.5 by 4, and the cardstock is 2 3/4 by 4 1/4. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to glue this down really good onto the front of this. And it's gonna, again, give you a little bit of a border all the way around, so you can kind of see the white envelope behind there. Look how cool that is. Isn't that neat, you guys, so far? Then on the outside, I used my 2 1/4 inch circle punch. In advance, I punched out the circle using the Petal Pink cardstock. And I'm just gonna go ahead and adhere that on with a dimensional. Find them here. Got stuff everywhere. So I'm just gonna use my mini dimensionals because that's all I can find right now, but they work just as well. So I'm gonna add a couple of mini dimensionals onto my project here. And if I had the bigger ones, they probably would work better, but these will work too. And I'm gonna adhere this down right here to the center. Now remember that flap that we cut off? This is the flap that I cut off from the inside of my little pocket holder. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to use this flap to stamp my outside sentiment and then cut it out with that 2-inch punch. Now what I should have used on the inside here is probably more like a 1-inch punch. I didn't have it here at my table, so I improvised, but I think you guys get the idea of how you want to have a little opening there for people to be able to grab what's in that gift card holder. So you could put money in there, you could put chocolate in there, you could do a little bit of everything, you know, anything that you might want to give, lottery tickets. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to stamp my happy birthday sentiment. Again, this is the flap of that envelope. So it's not even cardstock, but again, it's a good use of that little flap because, you know, why not? And then it will fit really nicely into this 2-inch punch. And you just kind of hang on to the sides. Let me make sure I get the right side here to hang on to. And it fits right in there, and you're just gonna punch your happy birthday. Perfect, right? And then you're going to just use your regular adhesive, and you'll have a little bit of the gumminess from your flap that you could also lick if you really wanted to, but I choose not to because that's kind of gross. I hate licking that stuff. And there you have a cute little gift card holder using our envelopes. And you could, again, decorate, even you could get really fancy and decorate the back. You could decorate in here. I chose to keep it very simple for you today, just to kind of show you the concept of our awesome envelopes to be able to make cute little, you know, gifts for people, their treat holders or birthday gifts. Sometimes it's nice just to give somebody a little something without it having to be you know, not in a card or something. You want to give it just a little something different, and this is perfect for that. And you're just going to tie up the side, and you're kind of going to twist it the way you want it. And, you know, you could also, I could also make this smaller and cut off the ends, but I kind of like it bigger like that. And there you have our cute little gift cards that you can make. These would be so easy to make in duplication, or a cute little thank you gift for somebody and giving them a you know, a gift card to go out to dinner or something like that. So I absolutely love how these turned out. So again, if you do not currently have a demonstrator and you would like to receive any of our new catalogs that came out about a month ago, please let me know. And I encourage you guys to also find me on Facebook. I do Facebook Lives every Thursday night at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And I'd love to have you join my Facebook group and like my page for me to be able to give you guys even more inspiration outside of my YouTube videos. So make sure you subscribe so you don't miss a thing. And I look forward to seeing you all back here soon. Bye.